Hello, children. Today I'm here to teach you chapter 11 in your textbook. That's decimals. You have already known about decimals. So in this lesson, we are trying to represent fraction with a denominator that can be written as a power of 10 as a decimal number, and then represent a decimal number as a fraction, multiply and divide a decimal number by a whole number. Convert fractions with denominator with multiples of 10 to decimals. Now look at the denominator. Denominator is 10. So what you do? This is 1 part of 10. So we can write this as 0.1. 2 parts of 10, how can we write down? 0.2. 3 parts of 10. 3 parts of 10, you can write 0.3. So 1 over 10 is 1 whole part and can be written as. So this is 1 over 10. We can write as 0.1. So 10 parts like that, 10 over 10 is equal to 1. So we can write 10 over 10 is equal to 1. So likewise, so what you do? Look at carefully when you are dividing by 10. Denominator is 10. Move the decimal place one place to the left. Can you see that? This one, one place to the left. One place to the left, 0.2. So likewise, can you give the decimal value there? Divide by 10. One place to the left, 1.2. 17 over 10 means divide by 10. One place to the left. You can write 1.7. 23 over 10. One place to the left, 2.3. Convert following fractions to decimals. So when you get the denominator 10, what you do? Move the decimal place one place to the left. Here to here, 0.8. Here to here, 0.4. 9 over 10, 0.9. 12 over 10. 1.2. 27 over 10, 2.7. 39 over 10, you get 3.9. 73 over 10, that's 7.3. And 44 over 10, that's 4.4. 128 over 10, that means 12.8, one decimal place to the left. Now we'll look at divide by 100. The denominator is 100. So you get 0.01. You move 2 places to the left. 8 over 100, 0.08. 21 over 100, 0.21. When the denominator is 100, 2 decimal places in the answer. So you see 2 decimal places in the answer. So write these in decimals. 28 over 100, move the decimal place 2 places to the left, 0.28. 2 places to the left here, you can put 0 for that. 0.9. 4 over 100, 1.2, 0.04. 87 over 100, move The decimal place two places to the left. 0.87. 84 over 100. Move two places to the left. 0.84. 0.84. Two places to the left. 0.93. 105 over 100. Two places to the left. 1.05. This one, two places to the left, 2.73. 315 over 100 means two places to the left, 3.15. So when you divide by 10, you move the decimal place one place to the left. When you divide by 100, move the decimal place two places to the left. Convert fractions without multiples of 10 in the denominator to decimals now. The denominator is not 10 nor 100 multiples of 10. So what we do? We have to convert the denominator to a multiple of 10. 5. How can we convert to multiple of 10? We can multiply by 2. So when you do that, you do the same thing for the numerator. So when you multiply 5 by 2, you have to multiply 2 by 2 as well. So you get 2 times 2, 4. 5 times 2, 10. Now we know how to write the decimal answer. 4 over 10, you can write 0.4. 3 over 4, how can you convert this one to a multiple of 10? 4 times 25 is 100. Multiply by 25. So you do the same thing in the numerator. 3 times 25. So 3 times 25 is 75 over 100. Now 75 over 100 is 0.75. 5 over 8. 8, how can we convert? So we can multiply by 125 to get 1000. So 5 times 125. So here you get 1000. 8 times 125. You get 1000. So what is 5 times 125? So you get 25 there. 5 times 2, 10. Plus 2, 12. 5 times 1, 5. Plus 1, 6. 625 over 1000. Move the decimal place 3 places to the left. 0.625. So when you don't get a multiple of 10 in the denominator, you can convert to a multiple of 10 and find out the decimal value. Convert fractions to decimals. So we'll do the same thing. 5 you can convert to 10. Do the same thing in the numerator. 8 over 10 you can write as 0.8. 2 is there. So how can you convert 2 to 10? Multiply by 5. So you multiply 1 also by 5. 5 over 10. What's the decimal value? 0.5. 11 over 20. So how do you get 100? 20 times 5. So multiply by 5. You get 55 over 100. That means 0.55. 33 over 50. So multiply by 2 to get 100. So 33 also multiply by 2. 66 over 100. So what's the decimal value? 0.66. 11 over 25. So 25 times 4 multiplied by 4. 11 times 4. So you get 100 here. And 11 times 4, you get 44. So what's the value? 0.44. This is 200. You can divide both the numbers by 2. So I can write 14 divided by 2 here, 200 divided by 2. So 7 over 100. So what's that? 7 over 100 I can write 0.07. So when you divide by 100, you get 2 decimal places. When you divide by 10, you get 1 decimal place. And when you divide by 1000, 3 decimal places. Convert mixed numbers to decimals. So first you can write 2 3/4 as 2 plus, that's the whole part, 3 over 4. Now you can convert this fraction to a decimal. So how you convert 4 to a multiple of 10? 4 times 25. So you do the same thing to the numerator. 2 is there. So you get 75 over 100. Now we know what is 75 over 100 as a decimal. That's 0.75. Now just add the whole number and the decimal number, you get 2.75. We'll do this one. 5 is the whole number and the fractional part is 11 over 20. Now try to convert to a multiple of 10. We can multiply by 5 to get 100. So do the same thing in the numerator, multiply by 5 to get, because we need 100 in the denominator. 5. 11 times 5, 55. 20 times 5, 100. Now write down the decimal value here. 55 divided by 100, 0.55. When you add these, you get 5.55. First, convert improper fraction to a mixed number and then convert to a decimal. So, how can we convert to a mixed number? Long division. How many 8s for 25? That's 3. 8 times 3, 24. 1 remaining, so 1 over 8. Now, we can write 3 and 1 over 8. 3 plus 1 over 8. Now, how we convert this one into multiples of 10? We can multiply by 125. Do the same thing. You get 325 over 8 times 125 is 1000. So 3 plus, when you divide by 1000 means move the decimal place 3 places to the left. 1.125. Now what's the answer? 3.125. We'll do this one. 12 divided by 5. First convert to a mixed number. 5 times 2, 10. 2 remaining. So 2/5. We can write this is 2 plus 2 over 5. Now convert to a multiple of 10 in the denominator. 5 times 2. Do the same thing. 2 plus 4 over 10. What's 4 over 10? That's 0.4. So what's the answer? 2.4. Convert fractions to decimals. So we'll use that method. Convert to a multiple of 10. Multiply both the numerator and the denominator by 2. So you get 8 over 10. What's 8 over 10? 0.8. 1/4 you can convert to 100 by multiplying this by 25. 25 times 4 is 100. Do the same thing. You get 25 in the numerator and 100 in the denominator. So 25 over 100 now, 0.25. 11 over 25. How can you convert to multiple of 10? You can multiply by 4. 25 times 4 is 100. So do the same thing to the numerator. So 44 over 100. 44 over 100 is 0.44. This one, 114 over 200. I can divide this by 2. Both the numerator and the denominator. So what you get? Divide by 2. You get 2 times 5, 10. Plus 14, that's 7. 57 over 100. 200 divided by 2. So you get 0.57. Now look at this one. 7 over 4 is an improper fraction. Convert to a whole number and a proper fraction. 7 over 4, I can write 1 and 3 fourths. Now 1 plus 3 fourths, I can convert to 100 here. 4 times 25 is 100. Do the same thing. 1 plus 75 over 100. What's 75 over 100? 0.75. I can write the answer as 1.75. This one, 12 over 5. 2 and 2 remaining, 2 fifths. So I can write, multiply this by 2 to get 10. 2 plus 4 over 10. Answer is 2.4. 4 over 10 is 0.4. This one, 2. And here you get 38 over 125. Then multiply by 4. What you get? Multiply by 8 to get 1000. You need multiples of 10. So 125 times 8. So what's the value? You get 1000 in the denominator. And 8 times 8, 64. 6 is remaining. 8 times 3, 24 plus 6. You get 304. Now you get 2. Move the decimal place 3 places to the left. 304. This one, 3 is there and the proper fraction is 17 over 20. Convert to multiples of 10. You can multiply by 5. Both the numerator and the denominator. So 3 is there. 17 times 5, 85. And here you get 100. So 3 plus 0.85. The answer is 3.85. So 85 over 100 is 0.85. Convert decimals to fractions now. So how we convert 0.7? In decimal, put 1 for the decimal point and zeros for the other numbers. So we'll see. This is decimal point is there. So put 1. And here, look at this one. You put 7. Here we are doing in the denominator. Put 1 for the decimal place and here only 1 place is there. So you put 0. So 7 over 10. This one, 0.8. 8 is there for the denominator. For point, that's 1. 1 place is there. So you put 0. You can simplify this fraction. Divide both the numerator by 2, you get 4 over 5. So that's an equivalent fraction. 0.23, convert to fractions. 23 is there. In the denominator, put 1 and 2 places are there. You put 2 zeros. This number, you can write as 1. 1 is a whole part. 0.423, you can write 423 over 1 with 3 zeros. So 1 and 423 over 1000. You can't simplify that. So what we do, you write down the number, divide by. For the decimal point, you put 1. And if there are 2 places, you put 2 zeros. If there are 3 places, you put 3 zeros. Convert to fractions in its lowest term. You can simplify. Okay, so here 27 is there. 2 places, so you put 1 and 2 zeros. Can we simplify? We can't simplify that. 0.43, 43 over 1 and 2 zeros, 100. 0.97, 97 over 100. We can't simplify. This one, 0.127. So you write 127. 1 is there for 0.123. 3 places are there. You put 3 zeros. 241. And here 1 and 3 places. Can we simplify these? We can't simplify. 333.333. You can write 333 over 1 with 3 zeros. 0.38. You can write 38 over 1 with 2 zeros. Now we can simplify. Both the even numbers. Divide by 2. You can divide by 2, 1 and 9. Divide 100 by 2, you get 50. So that's the fraction in its lowest term or simplest form. 0.45. 45 over 1 with 2 zeros. You can simplify. Divide by 5. 5 times 9. 5 times 20. 0.44. 44 divide by 1 with 2 zeros. Divide by what? You can divide by 4. You get 11 over 25. That's the simplest form or lowest term. 0.625. You can write 625 and 1 with 3 zeros. Divide by what? You can divide by 25. How many? 25 is what? 625. You get 2, that's 50, and 125 is remaining. So 25 times 5, 125. So you get 25 there. So here, how many 25s for 1000? You get 25 times 4 for 100, that's 40. But still, we can simplify. So when we divide by 5 again, you get 5 here, 8. So 5 over 8. 0.175. 175 over 1 with 3 zeros. Divide by 25 again. You get how many? 25 is for 175, 4 for 100, 3 for 75, 4 plus 3, 7. So 25 times 4 is 100, so you get 40, 7 over 40. 0.444 as a fraction, so 444 over 1 with 3 zeros. Divide by 4, 1, 1, 1. Divide by 4, this one, you get 4 times 25 here, so 250. You can't simplify further. Multiplication of decimals with whole numbers. So how we multiply a decimal number with a whole number? So the first thing is, ignore the decimal point. Just do normal multiplication and then consider how many places in the original question, and then you keep the decimal place in the appropriate place. So we'll do that. 0.3 times 2. 3 times 2, you get 6. So how many places are there? 1. So 1 place is there. So 0.6 is the answer. So what's the answer? 0.3 into 2, you get 0.6. Example, 0.4 times 3. Ignore the decimal. 4 times 3, 12. One place is there, only one place. So you keep point here, 1.2. This one, 11 times 3, 33. Now put the decimal point. So one place is there, so you get 3.3. So what you do, multiply the numbers without considering the decimal point, then count the decimal places in the given number and put the decimal place in the appropriate place. So here you get 3.3. Write the answer at once. 11 times 5, 55. One place is there, so you keep one decimal place. 11 times 7. Ignore the decimal. 11 times 7 is 77. Put one decimal place. So, point is here. 22 times 3. 66. One place is there. So, you put the decimal point here. 22 times 4. 88. One place is there. So, you keep the decimal point here. 1.4 times 2 means 14 times 2. 28. And put one decimal place. 14 times 3. 3 times 4, 12. 1 remaining. 3 times 1, 3 plus 1, 4, 42. One decimal place you have to keep. 2.18 into 3 means 218 times 3. 3 times 8, 24. 2 remaining. 3 times 1, 3 plus 2, 5. 3 times 2, 6. 654. How many places are there now? 2 places you have to keep. So the decimal point is here. 314 times 2. 2 times 4, 8. 2 times 1, 2. 2 times 3, 6. And 2 places are there. So point is here. 6.28. 613 times 7. 7 times 3, 21. 2 remaining. 7 times 1, 7 plus 2, that's 9. 7 times 6, 42. Again, 7 times 3, 21. 2 remaining. 7 times 1, 7 plus 2, 9. And 7 times 6, 42. How many places you have to keep now? 2 places. So the decimal point is here, 42.91. 72 into 8. 8 times 2, 16, 1 remaining. 8 times 7, 56 plus 1, 57. How many places? Just 1. So 57.6. Ignore the decimal place. First, just normal multiplication and then consider where you keep the decimal point. Write the answer at once. All these decimals multiplied by a whole number. 137 multiplied by 2. 2 times 7, 40. 1 remaining. 2 times 3, 6 plus 1, 7. 2 times 1, 2. 2 places are there. So the decimal point is here, 2.74. 315 times 3. 3 times 5, 15. 1 remaining. 3 times 1, 3 plus 1, 5. 3 plus 1, that's 4. 3 times 1, 3 plus 1, you get 4. So later we keep the decimal point. 3 times 3, 9. 2 places are there, so 9.45. 11 times this. 11 times 7, 77. 7 remaining. 11 times 8, 88 plus 7, you get 95. 9 remaining. 11 times 4, 44. 44 plus 9. 53. Where the decimal place? Two places there, so you have to keep two places and put the decimal point here. 9.16 times 12 multiplied by 12. So we can do separately. I'll do it here. 916 multiplied by 12. 10 and 2 multiplied by 1 now. Multiplied by 2. 2 times 6, 12. You get 2 times 1, 2 plus 1, 3. 2 times 9, 18. Now add it together. You get this. 2 times 6, 12. 1 remaining. 2 times 1, 2 plus 1, 3. 2 times 9, 18. When you add it, you get this number. How many decimal places? 2 there. So you have to keep the decimal place here. 109.92. Multiply by 13 now. 3.22. That means 322 multiplied by 13. 10 and 3. Multiply by 1 and 3. 3 times 2, 6. 6, 9. When you add it, you get 4186. Two places you have to keep, so the decimal point is here. 208 multiplied by 11. 11 times 8, 88. 11 times 2, 22. 2288. Now, how many places you have to keep? Just one. So, the decimal point is here. Multiply this by 2. 2 times 3, 6. 2 times 7, 14. 1 remaining. 2 times 1, 2 plus 1, 3. 2 times 5, 10. 3 places you have to keep. 1, 2, 3. So, 10.346. Multiply this by 3. 3 times 3, 9. 3 times 2, 6. 3 times 1, 3. 3 times 2, 6. 3 places you have to keep. Decimal point is here. Multiply this by 3. 3 times 4, 12. 1 remaining. 3 times 3, 9 plus 1, 10. 1 remaining. 3 times 1, 3 plus 1, 4. 3 times 2, 6. 3 places you have to keep the decimal point here. 6.402. 3.3 multiplied by 16. So 33 multiplied by 16. 10 and 6. Multiplied by 1 here and multiplied by 6. 18 and 18 plus 1, 19. Add these two. You get 8, 12, 1 remaining, 4 plus 1, 5. So how many decimal places we have to keep? Just one. So you get 52.8. Now we look at dividing decimals by multiples of 10. This is multiplication. What you do when you multiply by 10, move the decimal place one place to the right. You get 31.4. 31.4 multiplied by 10. Again, move the decimal place one place to the right, 340. Now, the opposite thing. Take this question. When you divide by 10, you have to move the decimal place one place to the left now. So, 31.4 divided by 10 means 3.14. So, remember that. When you get a multiple of 10 in the denominator, if it's 10, move one place to the left. Look at this one. Multiply by 100.
That means move the decimal place two places to the right here. 537.8. That's multiplication. Then here, same thing. That's 530. This one, two places to the right, 538.7. Now, this one, divide by 100. You move again two places to the left. So, the answer is the original one, 5.387.
So, 31.4 divide by 1000, what happens? 1, 2, 3. What happens? There's no number. So, put zeros for required places. So, you can write down. This is as 0, 3, 1, 4. Now, see, from here, 1, 2, 3. Three places to the left. If there's no number, put zero for that. Write the answer at once. Divide by 10. Move one place to the left. 3.87. We are talking about the decimal point. Divide by 10. Move the decimal point to the one place to the left. 2.93. Divide by 10. Move the decimal point one place to the left. 5.163. Divide by 10, move the decimal point one place to the left. Here, divide by 100, two places to the left, 5.148. Divide by 100, two places to the left, 6.735. This one, divide by 100, move two places to the left, 3.738. Divide by 100, two places to the left, 4.078. Divide by 1000, three places to the left. So what's the answer? 1, 2, 3, 6.1738. Divide by 1000 here, 1, 2, 3, 3 places to the left, answer is 7.4285. Write the answer at once. This number divide by 100, move the decimal place 2 places to the left, 0.915. Divide by 100, 2 places to the left, 0.825. Divide by 100 here, 5.731. Divide by 100. Now what happens here? You have to put zeros because when you are moving, there's another place there. So what's the answer? 0.00812. Look at this again. This is the decimal point here. 1, 2. When you divide by 100. Divide by 1000. 3 places to the left. 1, 2, 3. So that means you have to put zeros for that. 000934. Look at it again. The decimal point was here. 1, 2, 3. 3 places to the left. Write the answer at once. Same thing. Divide by 1000. 3 places to the left. 0.9121. Divide by 1000. 1, 2, 3. 3.4752. Divide by 1000 again. 1, 2, 3. There's no number, so you have to put 0 for that. 0732. Again, from here, 1, 2, 3. 3 places to the left. Divide by 1000. 1, 2, 3. We have to put a 0 there. 0914.
1251. Again, check from here. 1, 2, 3. The decimal point moves 3 places to the left. Write the answer at once. So, different numbers. Divide by 10, only 1 place to the left. Divide by 100, 2 places to the left. Divide by 100, 2 places to the left, 0.541. Divide by 1000, 1, 2, 3. You have to put a 0 there. 0.02795. Check it again. 7, 1, 2, 3. Divide by 1000 again. Move the decimal place 3 places to the left. 0.5785. Now we'll see how we divide decimals by whole number. So you can use long division. So you have to write down, this is the number you have to divide. So 28.7. This is the divisor you write here. So now divide. How many sevens for 28? That's 4. 28. So you get 0. Now you have to align the decimal point in a column. So here you get the decimal point here. Now for 7, how many 7s? Just 1. So you get 0. So what's the answer? 4.1. So 28.7 divided by 7 is 4.1. So always remember, keep the decimal point in a column. 47.4 divided by 6. This is the number you need to divide. This is the divisor 6. How many 6s for 47? That's 7. 42. When you subtract, you get 5. Now you have to put the decimal point in the column. Now 54, we take the 4 there. So 54, how many 6s? 6 times 9, 54. So the remainder is 0. So what's the value there? So here 6 times 7, 42. 6 times 9, 54. So exactly divisible. So you can write 47.4 divided by 6 is 7.9. Find the value of this. So what's the number there? 57.54. And you have to divide by 12. So how many 12s for 57? You get 4. 4 times 2, 8. 4 times 1, 4. What's the remainder? You get 9. Now you have to keep the dot aligned with this decimal point. Now for 95, how many 12s? 8 is 96 and you can get 7. 7 times 2, 14. And 7 times 1, 7 plus 1, 8. 84. So what's the remainder? You get 11 as the remainder. Then you can take the next number, 4. 414. How many 12s? You can get 9. 9 times 2, 18, 1 remaining. 9 times 1, 9, plus 1, 10. So what's the remainder there? 6. Now you can do again. So now you can put a 0. You can take any number of zeros. So I can take another 0. For 60, I know that's 12 times 5, 60. So you get remainder 0. So
So till you get remainder zero, you can do the division. So put zeros for the last number. So we put a zero. So here, I'll write down what we got. We got 48 and 12 times 7, 84. 12 times 9, 100. 8 and 12 times 5, we got 60. So what's the answer? We can write 4.795 is the answer when you divide the number by 12. Find the value. So 26.6 divided by 7. So we'll divide. How many 7s? 7 times 3, 21. What's the remainder? You get 5. Align the dot, the decimal point, with this 1. Now take 6. 7 times 8 is 56. That's 8. So you get remainder 0. So what's the answer? 3.8 is the answer. Find the value of this one. 49.2 divided by 6. So 6 times 8, 48. So you write 48 there. Subtract, you get 1. Now you have to put the decimal point aligned with this 1. So for 12, 6 times 2, 12. So you write 2 here. The remainder is 0. Till you get the remainder 0, you can divide. So what's the answer? 8.2. Look at this question. Find the value of this. 29.88 divided by 9. So this number divided by 9. 9 times 3, 27. Remainder is 2. So put the decimal point in a column. Then for 28 again, 9 times 3, 27. Now you get 18. So 9 times 2, that's 18. So this is 2. 18, you get remainder 0. So what's the answer? 3.32. So same thing as long division, but make sure that you keep the decimal point in a column. Look at this one. Length of a wire is 88.2 meters. Find the length of the wire if it cuts into 6 equal parts. So that means you have to divide this by 6. 6 times 1, 6. 2 remaining. For 28, 6 times 4, 24. And 4 remaining. Then you have to put the decimal point in that column. For 42, 6 times 7. So remainder is 0. So what's the length of one part? 14.7 meters. Look at this one. Price of 3 kilos of dal is 414.75. Find the price of 1 kilo. So you have to divide this by 3. So 414.75 divided by 3. So we'll write it here and do the long division. Divide by 3. 3 times 1, 3. 1 remaining. For 11, that's 3 times 3, 9. 2 remain. Take 4. For 24, 3 times 7. 3 times 8. 3 times 8, 24. So nothing there. But we have to take the other number. 7 is there. So what's the number? 3 times 2, 6 now. 1 remain. Now take the next number. For 15, 3 times 5.
That's 15. So remainder is 0. So you can put remainder 0. Now what's the answer? What's the price of 1 kilo? That's 138.25. So that means 138 rupees and 25 cents. Price of 7 liters of milk is 726.04. Find the price of 1 liter of milk. So what's the 1 liter of milk? So that means you have to divide by 7. So you can write down price of 1 liter is equal to 726.04 divided by 7.
We'll do the calculation here.
726.04 divided by 7. 7 times 1, 7. For 2, that's nothing. For 26, 7 times 3, 21. 5 remaining. Now you have to put the decimal point there. For 50, 7 times 7, 49. 1 remaining. For 14, that's 7 times 2, 14. So remainder is 0. So what's the answer? So price of 1 liter of milk is rupees 103.72.
Look at the other question. The distance traveled by 12 revolutions of a bicycle tire is 42.84 kilometers. Find the distance traveled by 1 revolution. So what you do?
You take the total distance for 12 revolutions and divide this by 12 to get the distance for 1 revolution. So we'll do long division. 42.84 divided by 12. 12 times 3, 36. What's the remainder there? You get 6. Keep the decimal point. For 68, how many 12s? 12 times 5. That's 60. 8 remaining. For 84, how many 12s are there? 7. 7 times 2, 14. And 7 times 1, 7 plus 1, 84. So the remainder is 0. So what's the answer? The distance by 1 revolution is 3.57 kilometers.
Look at the exercises in your textbook. Example 1. Write each of the following fractions as a decimal number. So what we do?
We write down the number and see how many zeros. 1, 2, 3. You keep 3 places. The point, decimal point, 3 places to the left. 1, 2, 3 places to the left. 1, 2, 3. 0.004.
97 divided by 100. Keep 3 places to the left.
You write 97. 1, 2, 3. 0.097. 751. 3 places. 3 zeros are there. 1, 2, 3. 0.751.
So move the decimal point 3 places to the left. Exercise 11.1. Express each of the following fractions as a decimal number. Represent them on an abacus. So here, decimal number
divided by 10. That means move the decimal place 1 place to the left. So that's 0.9.
Divide by 100 means move the decimal point 2 places to the left.
Divide by 1000 means move the decimal place 3 places to the left. Divide by 1000 means move the decimal place 3 places to the left. 1, 2, 3. 275. Move the decimal place 3 places to the left. So 275, 1, 2, 3. So 0.275. So how can we represent them on an abacus? So we can draw the abacus like this. This is one decimal place. I'll first 1, 2, 3. This one 1, 2, 3. I'll draw 4. Here I'll draw 4 here. 1, 2, 3, 4. And this one also I'll draw 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so I'll put the numbers. So this means units place and this is tens place. So this is ones place and this is 1/10 place. That means tens. So 9 is there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So you have to put 9 beads. 0.75, that's tens place. So I'll write ones place. This is tens place and hundreds place. So 7 is in tens place. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 there. 5 in hundreds place. Hundreds. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And this one, if it's ones place, this is tens place, hundreds place, and this is thousands place. 3 decimal places. So you get 9 in the thousands place. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So you can put 9 beads in thousands place. This one 3 decimal place. So ones place, tens place, hundreds place and thousands place. So here nothing in the tens place and 2 in hundreds place and 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 in thousands place. This number 0.275. So I can put ones place, 1/10. This is 1/10. 1/100, that means hundreds place. 1/1000. 275. So 2 is in tens place. 7 in hundreds place. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And 5 in thousands place. So that's how we can represent these decimals on an abacus. Example 1. Express each of the fractions as a decimal number. So what's the first step? Take this one and you need to convert the denominator to multiples of 10. So multiply by 2. So you do the same thing to the numerator. So 1/5. I can multiply both the numerator and the denominator by 2. So you get 2/10. So how can you write down the decimal value? 0.2. 13/25. So 13/25, I can multiply by 4. To get 100. So 100 in the denominator, and this one 4 times 3, 12, 4 times 1, 4 plus 1, 5, 52 over 100. So what's the number? Move the decimal point 2 places to the left, 0.52.
This one, 125, 77 over 125, multiplied by 8 to get 1000 in the denominator. 8 times 7, 56, 5 remaining. 8 times 7, 56, plus 5, 61. So 616, divide by 1000, move the decimal place 3 places to the left. So you get here 616 over 1000. That's equal to 0.616.
Example number 1. Express 9 over 8 as a decimal number. So this is 9 over 8 is an improper fraction. You can write as a whole number. That's 1 and 1 over 8. Now you can convert 8 to a multiple of 10. 8 times 125. You get 1000 there in the denominator. 125 here. Then you can write 1 plus. So when you divide by 1000, move the decimal place 2 places to the 3 places to the left. So 0.125. So the answer is 1.125. You can do without converting to a whole number and a fraction. Just we can convert the denominator 8 to 1000. Multiply by 125. What you get? 9 times 5, 45. 4 remaining. 9 times 2, 18. 18 plus 4, 22. 2 remaining. And 9 times 1, 9 plus 2, 11. Here you get 1000. So that means move the decimal point 3 places to the left, 1.125. So you can do either this way or this way, but when you take this one, you get a big number to multiply. But the answer is the same. Exercise 11.2. Express the following fractions and mixed numbers as decimal numbers. 3 over 5. So how can we convert to multiples of 10? Multiply by 2. So you get 6 over 10. So what's the decimal value? 0.6. 3 over 4. Convert to multiple of 10. Multiply by 25. Because 25 times 4 is 100. So 3 times 25, that's 75. 75 over 100, you can write as 0.75. Move the decimal point 2 places to the left. 8 over 25, multiply by 4, both the numerator and the denominator, because you are getting 100 in the denominator. 8 times 4, 32. 32 divided by 100 means 0.32. This one, 500. So multiply by 2 to get 1000. 2 times 1, 2. 2 times 2, 4. 2 times 3, 6. Over 1000. So that means move the decimal point 3 places to the left. 0.642. 39 over 40. Multiply by 25. Why? When you multiply it by 25, you get 1000. That's 20 and 5. Multiply by 2, that's 78 here, 5 times 9, 45, 4 is there, 5 times 3, 15, plus 4, 19. So you get 975. When you divide by 1000 means 3 places to the left, 0.975. 13 and a half. So I can write this one as 13 plus half. Half, how can I convert to multiples of 10 here in the denominator? Multiply by 5. So 13, 5 over 10. 5 over 10, I can write 0.5. So 13 plus 0.5. 13.5. This one you can write 2 and 7 over 50. 50 I can multiply by 2 to get 100. 2 plus 14 over 100. So what's 14 over 100? 0.14. Move the decimal point 2 places to the left. So you get 2.14. This one, you get 2 and 1 over 8. This one, I can multiply by 125 to get 1000. 2 plus 125 over 1000. So I get 2 plus 0.125. So that's 2.125. 3, 7 over 40. So I can write 3 plus 7 over 40. Multiply by 25 to get 1000. 3 plus 7 times 5, 35, 3 remaining, 7 times 2, 14, plus 3, 17. Over 1000. So I can write 3 plus 0.175. Final answer is 3.175. Listen up. 125 in the denominator. This is 125. I can multiply this by 8 to get 1000. 8 times 4, 32, 3 remaining. 8 times 1, 8 plus 3, 11. So this is 1000. Now you can write this one as 5. Plus 0.112, answer is 5.112. 13 over 10, I can write as a whole number, that's 1 and 3 remaining out of 10, 3 over 10. What's 3 over 10? 0.3. So the answer is 27 over 20, that's a improper fraction. I can write one part is there, that's 27 remaining, 7 over 20. Now I can convert to multiple of 10, that's multiplied by 5. Do the same thing in the numerator, 1 plus 35 over 100. So what's 35 over 100? That's 0.35. 1 plus 0.35, you get 1.35. 7 over 5, 1 whole part and 2 remaining out of 5. How you convert to multiples of 10? Multiply by 2. 1 plus 4 over 10. 4 over 10 is 0.4. So, answer is 1.4. 4. This one, 97 over 8. How many 8s are there? 1 for 17, that's 2. 16. So 1 remaining. 1 over 8. Then this is 12 plus 1 over 8. You multiply by 125 to get 1000 there. So you get 12 plus 125 over 1000. What's the answer? 12.125, because this number is 0.125. Move the decimal place 3 places to the left. This one, 250. One part is there and one is remaining out of 250. Multiply this by 4. So you get 1000 in the denominator. So what's 4 over 1000? 1 plus 0.004. Move the decimal place 3 places to the left. So the final answer is 1.004. Example number 1. Express 1.625 as a fraction in its simplest form.
1.625.
Now convert to a fraction. So what you do? So this means 1 plus 0.625. How can I write this one? This is multiplied by 1000. 625 over 1000, because you get 3 decimal places. Now simplify. You can simplify the fraction. 25 times 40. 25 times 25. You get 625. Again, you can divide by 5. 5 times 8. 5 times 5. So what's the fraction? 1 and 5 over 8. You can write this as a mixed number, 1 and 5 over 8. Exercise 11.3. Write each of the following decimal numbers as a fraction and express it in the simplest form. 0.7. So you need to write down this number as a fraction. So this is one decimal place, means 7 over. So that's the simplest form. 1 is there. 0.3. 0.3 you can write down as 3 over 10. So 1 and 3 over 10. This one, 0.45. You can write this one as 45 over 100, because 2 decimal places are there. So put 1 for the decimal point and 2 zeros for 2 places. Now divide by 5. 5 times 9 and 5 times 20. So that's the simplest form. 8.16. This means 8 and you get 0.16. 0.16, how can you write as a fraction? 16 over 100. Now, you can simplify. Divide by 2, you can divide by 4. 4 times 4, 4 times 25. So, what's the fraction? 8 and 4 over 25. 6.75. 6 is there. 0.75, you can write 75 over 100. Divide by 25, that's 3 and 4 here. So 6 and 3 over 4.
0.0253 places are there.
So I can write 25 over 1000. Because 1, 2, 3.
3 places after the decimal point.
So 25 times 1. 25 times 4 here. 40. So 1 over 40.
4.225.
That means 4 and 0.225. I can write this as 4 and this one as 225 over 1000 because 3 places are there.
Now divide by 25.
I get 40 here. 25
times 4 is 100. So 8 and 9. So what's the answer?
4 and 9 over 40.
8.625.
That means 8 plus 0.625. I can write this as 625 over 1000. So 25 times 25, 625, 25 times 40. Again, you can divide by 5, that's 5 and 8. So the answer is 8, 5 over 8.
Example number 1. Multiply a decimal value with a whole number. So what you do? You ignore the decimal place and just multiply. 4, 2, 7, 6 multiplied by 12. 10 and 2.
Multiply by 1 first and 2. 2 times 6, 12. 2 times 7, 14 plus 1, 15. 2 times 2, 4 plus 1, 5. 2 times 4, 8. 6 plus 1, 11. 8, 8 plus 5, 13. 11 and 5.
Now, you have to think about the decimal point.
3 places are there in the question. That means you have to keep 3 places. So what's the answer? 51.312.
Exercise 11.4. Evaluate the following. Multiply the two numbers without any decimal point.
We'll first multiply 6 times 5, 30. 3 remaining. 6 times 4, 24 plus 3, 27. 2 remain. 6 times 2, 12. 12 plus 2, 14. 2 places are there, so you have to keep 2 decimal places.
0.75 times 4 means 75 times 4 first. 4 times 5, 20. 2 remaining. 4 times 7, 28 plus 2, 30.
Now keep 2 decimal places. So the answer is 3.
This one.
347 multiplied by 15. 10 and 5. First multiply by 1. By putting 0 there, you get this number. 5 times 7, 35. 3 remaining. 5 times 4, 20 plus 3, 23. 2 remaining. 5 times 3, 15 plus 2, 17. When you add it,
you get 5,205.
2 places are there, so you keep 2 decimal places. So the answer is 52.05.
This number?
1,528 multiplied by 13, 10 and 3. Keep 0 and multiply by 1. 3 times 8, 24. 3 times 2, 6 plus 2, 8. 3 times 5, 15. 1 remaining. 3 times 1, 3 plus 1, 4. 8 and 8, 16. And 6 plus 2, 8, and you get 9 and 1. So 2 places you have to keep. Answer is 198.64.
multiply by 3 without considering the decimal.
3 times 5, 15. 1 remaining. 3 times 5, 15 plus 1, 16. 3 places you have to keep. 1, 2, 3. So the answer is 0.165.
This one multiplied by 41.
1357 multiplied by 41, that means 40 and 1. 4 times 7, 28, 2 remaining. 5 times 4, 20. 20 plus 2, 22, 2 remaining. 4 times 3, 12 plus 2, 14, 1 remaining. 4 times 1, 4 plus 1, 5. And when you multiply by 1, you get this number. Now add it. Get this. 3 places you have to keep. So answer is 55.637.
Exercise 11.5. Evaluate the following. Multiply by 10. So when you multiply by 10, move the decimal place one place to the right.
47.4. Here, multiply by 10. One place to the right, 5.03. Here, multiply by 10. One place to the right, 0.79.
Two places to the right when you multiply by 100,
583.
Multiply by 100.
Move the decimal place two places to the right. 537.9.
Multiply by 100, two places to the right, answer is 7.
Two places to the right, so you have to put a 0 there,
120. One place to the right, 0.056.
Multiply by 100, move the decimal place two places to the right, 0.12, so 3, not 0. Two places to the right, so 3.07.
Multiply by 1000 means three places to the right, 1, 2, 3, for the numbers. These places you have to put 0. So 2 zeros you have to keep.
Multiply by 1000. 1, 2, 3. 8073.2.
Multiply by 1000. Move the decimal place 3 places to the right. 6005.1. Exercise 11.6. Evaluate the following. Now, divide by 10. What happens? The decimal point move to the left by one place. So, move one place to the left.
Answer is 2.71. Divide by 10 means move one place to the left. 0.136. One place to the left. 0.026. Here, one place to the left. 0.0037. Divide by 10 means another one more decimal place. So, you get 0.00059.
Divide by 100,
two places to the left, 0.589. Divide by 100, move the decimal point two places to the left, 0.037. Divide by 100, 1, 2, two places to the left, 976. Divide by 100, another two places to the left, 0.00075. Divide by 100. Another two more places. You get 0.1234. And then 32. So think about, again, this is the number given. 1, 2. Divide by 1000, three places to the left. 1, 2, 3. Answer is 4.3758.
Divide by 1000, move the decimal place, 0.3 places to left.
0.3568.
Example number one, find the value of this. So this is long division. So what you do,
you take the number, divide by 7.
7 times 2, 14. Then 7 times 2, 14, 4 remaining. So 42.
So 7 times 6, 42. And 0 remained. Now, you have to align this point here. So you have to put a decimal point. Then for 3, that's nothing. For 35, that's 7 times 5, 35. So here for 35, 7 times 5, 35. So remainder is 0. So what's the answer? 26.05.
Find the value of 0.672 divided by 12.
Here, nothing. So you have to align this dot here.
For 6,
that's nothing. For 67, 12 times 5, 60. So 7 remaining. For 72, that's 6. 72, remainder is 0. So what's the answer? 0.056.
This one, 2.13.
Divide by 4. For 2, there's nothing, 0. Then align the dot with this column. You have to have the dot decimal point in a column. Then 4 times 5, that's 20. Now subtract, you get 1. For 13, 4 times 3, you get 12. So 1 remaining. So you can take a 0. For 10, 4 times 2, 8. 2 remaining. You can take another 0. 4 times 5, that's 20. Now you see, you get 0 remainder. So the answer is 0.5325.
Exercise 11.7. Evaluate the following. So long division.
So we'll do 84.6 divided by 2. 2 times 4, 8. 0 remainder. 4 you take, so 2 times 2, that's 4, that's also 0. Now, put a decimal point here. For 6, 2 times 3, you get 6. So, 0 remaining. So, answer is 42.3.
This one, again long division, 167.2 divided by 4. For 1, nothing. 4 times 4, 16. So, 0 remaining. For 7, that's 1. 3 remaining. Now, take 2. 4 times 8, 32. So, you get 0 remainder. So, the answer is 41.8. This one, 54.6, divide this by 3.
3 times 1, 3. 2 remaining. For 24, that's 8. 0 remaining. Now put the dot here in the column. And for 6, this is 3 times 2, 6 and 0 remaining. So what's the answer? 18.2. Take the other one. 98.58 divided by 6. 6 times 1, 6. 3 remaining. For 38, 6 times 6, 36. 2 remain. Now put a decimal point there. Take 5. 6 times 4, 24. 1 remain. And for 18, that's 6 times 3, 18. 0 remain. Answer is 16.43. 74.5 divided by 5. Long division again. 74.5 divided by 5. 5 times 1, 5. For 24, that's 4. You get 20 and 4 remaining. Put the dot here. And for 45, 5 times 9. So 0 remaining. Answer is 14.9. 35.86 divided by 2. 2 times 1, 2. 1 remaining. Now take the next number. For 15, 2 times 7, 14. 1 remaining. The decimal point. Now take 8. So you get 9. 2 times 9, 18. 0 remaining. Now take 6. How many 2s? 2 times 3. So 0 remaining. Answer is 17.93. 0.684. 0.684 divided by 6. This is nothing. Put the decimal point. For 6, that's 1. Nothing remaining. Now take the next number, 8. 6 times 1, 6. Remainder 2. For 24, take the next number, 24, 6 times 4, 24, and the remainder is 0. So what's the answer? 0.114. Next one, 0.735 divided by 7. For 0, that's nothing. Put the decimal point, 7 times 1, 7. 0 remaining. Now take 3. Nothing for 3. So for 35, that's 5. 7 times 5, 35. 0 remaining. Answer is 0.105. This one again, long division. 1.08 divided by 4. For 1, that's nothing. Put the decimal point. For 10, that's 4 times 2, 8 and 2 remain. Now take the next number, 28. 4 times 7, 28 and 0 remaining. 0.27. This one, 7.401 divided by 3. 3 times 2, 6. 1 remain. Now put the decimal point. For 14, 3 times 4, 12. Now 2 remaining. Now take the next number, 20. 3 times 6, 18. 2 remaining. And take the next digit, 1. 3 times 7, 21. And remainder is 0. So the answer is 2.467. This one, 8.04 divided by 8. For 8, that's 1. 0 remaining. Now put the decimal point. For 0, that's nothing. For 4, that's also nothing. Now take 0 there. So you can take another 0. For 40, 8 times 5, 40. So 0 remaining. Answer is 1.005. Now look at this one. 11.745 divide by 9. 9 times 1, 9. 2 remaining. Now put the decimal point. For 27, that's 9 times 3. 27. 0 remain. Now take the next digit, 4. That's nothing. No 9s for 4. Now take the next one, 45. 9 times 5, 45. The remainder is 0. So what's the answer? 1.305. Question number 2. If the height of a child is 145 centimeters, express this height in meters. So what's the conversion? Centimeters to meters. You need to divide this by 100. So when you are dividing by 100, what happens to the decimal point? Moves 2 places to the left. 1, 2. So what's the answer? 1.45 meters. So we covered all theory related to decimals. So when multiplying a decimal number by a whole number, consider the decimal number as a whole number by disregarding the decimal point and multiply the two numbers. Place the decimal point in the answer that is obtained so that it has the same number of decimal places as the original decimal number. When a decimal number is multiplied by a power of 10, the number of places the decimal point in the decimal number shifts to the right is equal to the number of zeros. And when you divide, what happens? It shifts to the left depending on number of zeros. So practice all exercises and examples and thorough with decimals and how we convert all the decimals to fractions and other way around, because you need this part in future.